name is K.E. Felix, and I welcome you to K.E. Felix Inspire. Always remember, if you're coming here for the first time, please don't forget to subscribe. Hit the bell icon so that you get notified whenever I post new videos. Please do stay tuned for more details in this video.
The emergency DNC meeting that sat this morning, I decided that first of all, we are a law-abiding party. And we've got our constitution, which constitution provides guidance on how to deal with matters of this nature. So we are going to follow our own constitution. So what we have decided as a DNC is that our three colleagues are put on suspension immediately. They have been placed on suspension immediately. Whilst they are claiming to have expelled President Kalama, the three of them, I want to tell them and tell the nation that they said the National Committee of the DP is the one that has decided to suspend the three colleagues. Yes. And we are going to write them exculpatory letters, which letters they will have to respond to in the next 14 days. Failure to which, or even if they respond, and depending on their response, then the DNC will sit again to make a final decision. So for now, Mr. Justin Nkonge, Judith Kabemba, and Evans Chirambwe stands suspended by the National Committee of the Democratic Party. We will subject them to the disciplinary process of the party. So letters will be written to them to exculpate themselves. Thereafter, a final decision will be made. I think for now, that's all I can communicate to you with regard to whatever transpired yesterday. And I want to take this opportunity to ask all members of the DP across the country that we are the new hope.
Yes.
I want to take this opportunity to ask them to remain calm and just know that we are in control of this party.
Yeah.
A party can never be governed by three individuals. You can see our colleagues, our fellow leaders behind me here, and even those that have not managed because it was on short notice, they are in support of the decisions that we have made here. So all our members across the country remain calm and continue mobilizing. Continue mobilizing, because very soon we will start reconstituting our structures from the ward, constituents, district and provincial level. And even new members. I have been in politics to speak as a person. I have been in politics for 14 days. To speak as an individual, I have been in politics for 17 years. There is no political party that can grow without welcoming new members. So we are also encouraging new members to please feel free to join our party. Members from the Patriotic Front, you are welcome. Members from the UPND, you are welcome. Members from the Socialist Party, you are welcome. Members from the Party for Honorable Amdudu, you are welcome. Even those members that have not joined the political party before, you are welcome. We want to grow. We can only grow if we open doors for new members. Very important. There's no political party that closes its doors to new members. And it's not everybody who was in PF was bad. That's not true. PF was voted by 1.8 million people. All those 1.8 million people you are telling me were bad heads? No, we need the good heads from the 1.8 million people to join us so that we become stronger than we were. Thank you so much, members of the press. Unless you have questions, I would want to, unless you have questions, I would like to after my address, invite the president also to say one or two things so that the Labamo and Equati in Binawa we now are silenced. Unless there are questions.
Questions for last time.
Okay, I'm advised that the questions will come even after the president addresses the press as well. So thank you so much for your attention. That is the position of the party national committee, which is the supreme organ of the party. Anything other than that, consider it null and void. And whatever they want to do, I can assure them, those three colleagues, that we are equal to the task. We will take them on, and they will be made solid. And they will be made solid, that I can assure you. Thank you so much.
Thank you very much. First of all, I am very delighted to receive all of you to the party secretariat, and I want to thank wholeheartedly the Democratic National Committee of our party. I sit here energized, or stand here energized, because the DNC of our party has just reaffirmed its confidence in the leadership that you have started from years back. You will recall that this journey has not been without drama. We have had to be stopped in so many ways by surrogates. We have had to be stopped in so many ways by people who fall along the line for money. Colleagues will recall that I walked out on the patriotic front in 2017 on the 17th of December on account of corruption. And I said the PF was corrupt. And I said never will I ever return to the PF. So when you hear like a Budo, who are trying to make a noun out of my name, you realize that things are not easy. I can tell you that I am delighted, and I'm very confident that our party, which is one of the most organized political parties, is going to handle its own internal challenges very smoothly. I think we have a team of men and women who are equal to the task. Yeah. And that myself as president, my job is easy. Mine is just to watch and move on. Yes. We continue with our mobilization programs as a party. We will not be deterred, just as we were not deterred when the PF cancelled our certificates. We continued mobilizing, we continued working hard. And even now, we'll continue even doing this much more. Oh, yes. Because the DP is the party people are counting on. Mm-hmm. And we carry the burden of those people on our shoulders. And those who think that they can come in between and stand on the way of this aspiration, they have drawn a blank. Mm-hmm. Because the DP will still emerge triumphant.
Yes.
You can be hired in whatever sort. You can have your own special relations of whatever sort. But the DP will still emerge victorious.
Oh, yes.
And this I can assure you. As the National Secretary has said, when we began the race for presidency, we didn't start to end tomorrow. I was telling you the other day that if I don't win the elections, or if we don't win as a party in 2026, in the unlikely event we don't win, that will not be the end of the journey. We'll continue to 2031.
Yes.
If we don't win in 2031, we'll continue to 2036.
Yes.
If we don't win in 2036, we'll continue to 2041 until they don't decide. We have seen challenges, and I can tell you this is nothing. We are going to overcome many challenges coming ahead of us because we are growing as a political party. And as we are growing as a party, we'll brace ourselves, and the DNC of our party will continue bracing itself for the new and old challenges that lie ahead. And me, as your leader, that you have chosen at this, at a moment such as this, at a defining moment of our country, I can tell you with certainty that I carry the cross with no reservations.
Amen.
I left the PF because of corruption and indiscipline. And even as you have today said, you have still reaffirmed my being president of the DP, I can still tell you that indiscipline will not be part of me. And even if you think you are my best friend, you might think you are close to me, if it is indiscipline, we'll part company. No indiscipline soldier wins a war.
That's right.
And so we'll continue on that path as a party, because with discipline we are going to achieve a lot. So thank you very much for coming. God bless you. Bless you. Thank you.
Welcome to